the following paper presents results, specifics, and problems which we are dealing with during research in Bagish woodlands in northern part of Poland. Area of woodland which we are interested in belongs to the Kołobrzeg city and is located in the middle northern part of Polish Baltic coast. Research area covers approximately 1,400 hectares. So this is Kołobrzeg city, and that's the place, the area of research, and that's mostly the place where all the sites that will be analyzed are located. The area was formed by Vistulian glacier. The entire forest is not heavily modified by man, mostly because terrain was closed until 1990s, early 1990s, when the Soviet airbase in Bagish was closed and abandoned by Russian troops, and then the area was reopened to the public. It is dominated by oak and beech trees. However, intensive forestry is carried out at present. The oldest oak tree within the area is named Bolesław, and it is about 800 years old. The whole area is part of the Nature 2000 project. Beginning of the research of the area is connected with a discovery of big barrow cementary in 2016 on airborne laser scanning digital terrain model derivative. So basically, this is the cementary we're talking about, and it was discovered by coincidence. I was searching through the data, looking at the former Soviet base for buildings which were related to the storage of nuclear warheads, and then I noticed that place, and I said, asked Marta if she can check it out, and she discovered that this is actually something meaningful. So this is also the question: when the archaeological discovery is made, when we notice something, or when we actually learn what it is and see and can narrative its value. I believe this is the second case: when we actually learn something about the place, then we make a discovery, not through basic notice of something that is quite unusual and should not be there. So, due to geographical division of Poland, the cementery is located on the border of two mesoregions, Slovenian coast and Białogard plain, approximately 2.5 kilometers from the Baltic seashore. Sea is located on a slope of moraine upland at the height of 16 to 18 meters above sea level. And now something about the data we use. Information about special plan of the site came from analysis of ALS DTM derivatives. The data was taken from ESOT governmental program. Average density of processed point cloud was about 4 points per square meter. Archaeological site was scanned on 5th of April 2012, and it had a positive influence on the quality of collected data, because in this period vegetation was not intensive and LiDAR penetration was quite high. The point cloud was reclassified for the purpose of identification of archaeological relics. Created DTM had cells of size 0.5 meter by 0.5 meter. Based on obtained DTM, several derivatives were created, and some of them you can see here. And that kind of visualization was then interpreted in GIS environment. The obtained data was vectorized to generate spatial plan of the cementary and to determine the approximate number of the mounds present in the area. Additionally, the results of interpretations were verified during field reconnaissance, field walking, to recognize chronology of the site. The decision was made about limited excavation of excavations of one of the barrows. Analysis of field walking analysis and field walking verification led to the conclusion that altogether about 57 mounds of varying size are present at site. Diameter of well-preserved mounds ranges from 7 to 25 meters, and barrow on eastern side of the road seems to be better preserved, and their height varies from 0.4 to 1.5 meters. So, as you can see, the road cut the cementary to the hub, and then later on I will be talking about that as well. Unfortunately, part of the site was seriously damaged. At least 10 mounds were destroyed by construction of the road by German Wehrmacht during their retreat from the airbase in Bagish at the end of Second World War. In most cases, barrows were cut in half by the road. There is no information about any finds which may appear during construction works, but we have to remember that it was last month of the war, so nobody really cared about archaeology or anything else besides war. Other destructions were caused by heavy vehicles, and off-road cars. Because of very wet terrain, car wheels deeply penetrated the ground. This situation led to a serious damage of their structure. Also, activity of wild animals like foxes, badgers has an impact on their state of preservation. Noteworthy is the destruction activity of detectors who happened to looking for some treasures there as well. The central part of the mound that was designated for archaeological excavation was destroyed, which most certainly was a result of mechanical removal of a tree growing on the barrow stop. Traces of this action are quite well visible on the LiDAR derivatives. It was also confirmed by terrain profiles based on DTM. Perimeter of the mound was quite well visible, with an exception in the northwestern part. During excavations, we noticed that barrow adheres to a small mound which was not being visible at the beginning of the research. So basically, you got barrow here, which was excavated. This is the place of destruction from removal of the tree that was growing on the top of it. And that's the place where the small mound was located due to excavation. So actually, you can see that it is visible at the derivative, but at the beginning, during the analysis of this derivative, we did not notice it. So again, the question when the discovery is actually made, and we have this featured in the data, we just did not notice it. And those are, of course, terrain profiles with the destruction visible in the middle. And those are some pictures from excavations, just to let you know how the site looks like in the forest. And during excavations, it was discovered that we are dealing with a barrow site of Gelbach culture. Of course, it shouldn't be there according to the current knowledge. So if you look at this map, this is the place where this barrow site is located. And before that, it was empty spot, and nobody thought that Gelbarkian site can be located within this area. It was perceived as empty space until now. During our excavations in the woodland, it turned out that many people knew about the site. It just happened that nobody ever reported it for various reasons, maybe mainly because they did not know how to report it and to whom. It appears that both forester and local residents have some knowledge about archaeological sites in the area. We have started to getting emails with information about sites, not necessarily in the woods, but we noticed that something was changing and people really wanted to cooperate with us. Thus, we formalized the project. Main purpose of our project is non-invasive archaeological research of the forest area between villages of Kongelno, Stramnička and Bagic, near Kołobrzeg, as well as surveys of the coastal area near the former Bagic airbase. And those are following project stages, so archival query, the analysis of airborne laser scanning data, some paleopathological and biochemical analysis, palynology, analysis from the context surrounding the sites, field verifications of the sites, of field walking, some limited excavations, geophysical surveys, and in the end, popularization of the results of the research. An important part of our project is cooperation with local environments such as museums, history enthusiasts, forest management, and metal detectors. Without them, conducting of our research would be impossible or at least very difficult. The forest ranger has the knowledge of what to take into account during field works. The local explorers and metal detectors are very helpful during surveys due to their experience with metal detecting equipment. At the same time, this cooperation led to grow a mutual trust, and thus shows the need for presenting the results in less scientific and more popular form. It is also important because the destruction of the mounds goes on. We finished first stage of field surveys recently. We already took samples for palynology on the forested area. We noticed 5 new sites as well. We also started biochemical analysis of the graves from Bagic. And the new site, new barrow site was also located. It was registered to the interpretation of LiDAR data. Cementary is located in the area of Moren Hills with height of site 9 to 6 meters above sea level. We registered 20 barrows on site, the diameter of which is in the range of 5 to 7 meters, and the average height does not exceed 1 meter. The burial mounds are quite well preserved. They do not bear traces of destruction as a result of forest management or illegal penetration by the territory. So it appears that the site was unknown to anybody, even the local residents. And we have no idea of the chronology of those barrows, but we will return there. And the distance of 800 meters from the Gilbarkian site, the site I was talking at the beginning about, objects were registered that look like another burial mounds and have to be verified. So those are such places. But we are not sure yet if those are actually barrows or something else, something related to the forestry management. Research of the Young Forest area resulted in discovery of few fragments of pottery and a brooch from the younger period of Roman Iron Age. We also found medieval arcs, probably remains of graveyard of Pomeranian culture. So that's this probably one of the graves there. Okay. In addition, during the research in the woods, we were able to register the object which could be interpreted as Neolithic rondel near the forest. This unusual discovery was confirmed by archaeological material recognized during salvage. So as you can see here, we've got vertical aerial photography, and I believe it was taken from Google Earth. And we can see here positive crop marks, which mark the place where the backfilled ditch was placed. And that's the field where the site is located. We put huge attention to the popular aspect of our research. So we are preparing website, we are going to schools, forestry, and local museums with lectures. In October, we will be filming our research. At the end of our project, we will present our research in a popular publication. In our case, the double-edged sword is the popularization of archaeology. We try not to keep our research secret, but to talk about it as much as possible. Therefore, we encountered various surprises, such as occasional destruction of burial mounds. Some other problems are related to the specifics of the surveys itself. Of course, surveys can only be carried out in the area of young forests. In other cases, we can try only to find artifacts in dens or pits, so we often do not have the possibility to state the chronology of sites. Despite many inconveniences, at the first stage of the research, we were able to register many archaeological sites in connection with this. The studies conducted by us covered the empty spots on the map that was the forest of Magic so far. The results are so interesting that they have a real influence on what we know about the archaeology of northern Poland. Already we have noticed two sites which should not be there according to the current knowledge. Therefore, we have nothing else but to re-enter the forest to continue our work. Thank you very much for your attention.